Hello friends, how are you all? From today onward we will learn about Clo3D. It's a very interesting software, you will be glad to learn about it. So let's begin the class. This is our to-do window in which we have so many options and toolbar. We can slide it from here. We can enlarge our 2D window or 3D window according to our need. See like this. These are various tools about which we will learn soon. In this side we have our 3D window. It has many options as well which will help us. From here we can split our view to see 2D window or vice versa. We can see our 3D window from here. These are our software. Oops tools. This grid is our platform, I'm showing you in detail. This is where our avatar will stand or even any object you will import will be shown here. This is our to-do window in which the pattern we develop or made will be visible. After that your avatar shape will be visible here at center too. These are our toolbar, these are menu properties, 2D pattern, 3D pattern, avatar, render, display, settings, and help. Alongside this is object browser where we have seams, fabric, button, buttonholes, top stitch. We can enlarge it from here. After that next we have puckering, grading and bomb. About that we will learn soon. Here we have property editor, elsewhere you click in 2D and 3D window the details will be shown here. Here we have hanger, garments, fabric and avatar. These options came with software by default. This is our stage 3D stage when you have to represent fashion show or something then we will use this. These are default avatars, females, males and kids as well. We have some default garment as well and this is our fabric library. It's a very huge library. We have cotton, cotton Oxford, satin, cotton stretch and this side we have history. Whatever work you will do will be saved here step by step. And here we have module configuration. You can resize it as well as per your comfort. Before learning anything we should learn about 2D window first so that we can learn comfortably. This is select tool. Whatever we will draw will be selected by this tool. As you can see its shortcut is A. So you just have to press A on your keyboard to activate this option. Like you can see right now we can use it now. Edit pattern. Edit pattern will help to edit the pattern you will make and its shortcut is Z. With this next tool we can give cures and this one is to add point in the curve. This is our point tool. If we want to make curve or to split we can do that by this tool's help. This is notch cutter. If we wish to give a smooth curve we can use this tool. So let's make shapes first. To make shapes we have options like polygon, rectangle and ellipse. First let's see how can we make rectangle in this. Either you can make it by keeping your left click on and dragging it simultaneously. You can see in your 3D window as well that it's displaying the same shape there already. See, its size is very big because we're making it randomly right now. We should go back to our 2D window. For other default options you have to just left click once. With this its properties will open. You can decide your width like here we will choose 10 inches. Let's make a square. So we have to take 10 inches in height as well and now click OK. Our small rectangle is ready. We have to zoom to look nicely. Press A on keyboard or go to your selection tool. Now our object is selected. We can move it anywhere we would like to. As I told you this is point tool with the help of which we can add point anywhere. While point tool selected you can see there are some values to decide at which distance we want to add point. This will help you. This is curvature tool with point you can add curve as well like this. In this as well you can decide how much curve you wish for. While keeping your left click you have to right click it. The properties will show up, distanced moved so we will add 2 inch here it's moving already. We can define x axis as well so we'll add 3 inches make any shape. Right now it's looking like a kite. Press Z to select edit tool. Now we can do more changes in it. This is our another curve tool by the help of which we can edit shape a little more. while pressing A. This is our rotation tool. You can call it a small kite. C. If you want to make shapes inside the pattern, we will select this option. Internal polygon means you can draw inside the pattern you have created. We have the same options here. The new option which we can see is start, about which we will discuss. First, let's see how to use internal polygon. I'm doing nothing special. After selecting this tool, you have to just left click as per the shape you wish for. Like this, if you want to end it, click at the first point. Your shape is finished now. It may take little time to finish this, but won't be that long. You can cut this shape, press C, right click and cut. It's all done now, it's a hollow shape. You can delete it as well by pressing delete on keyboard, or you can leave it as it is. You can drag these like this and press delete, it's done. Let's see options which are installed already. Double click on the avatar, let's check out female avatar. It has a name given by the people and that's Emma. Double click on it as well, now it will upload. Now we will open our default garment by double clicking it. In that garment we will open female garment that we have. File not saved, it doesn't matter to us. Would you like to? No. See our avatar and showing in 2D window as well, like we told you. Our file is download and this side our pattern is laying. If we click like this, it will be highlighted in 3D window as well to make it easy for us to work. This is our sleeve and this is color that rib here. This is another way to select pattern to select a specified area or pattern. This is our backside. The line you are noticing which are going through avatar are sewing lines. The way this garment should be stitched is already fixed for this garment. Now we are going to simulate it. You can see a small arrow at the top, it will help in simulation. The shortcut for simulation function is spacebar. So we will press spacebar and the simulation is done. See how nicely it's done. We can grab it as well to watch nicely to overview how our garment is looking. Right now there is no fabric specification particularly. We clicked on default fabric, now we see its properties. Fabric is mate, texture is not specified, we can change its color. Single click over color patch shown. Let's pick one color, we have a pre-selected color library here. So we should choose one color out of it. Dark color. Light color. Whatever color you would like to pick you can from our default library. We will choose something interesting out of these color. Aqua. So we will take a dark shade, press OK. It's done right now, it's highlighted because we were working over its fabric color. Click like this and now it's done. See how nicely it's fit to her. This side we have our avatar properties about which we will learn sooner. Thank you all. See you in next class. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to see new updates. You can ask your query in the comment section below. Bye bye.